Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit a logistic regression model that includes the interaction of a continuous predictor and a categorical predictor. And I'm going to show you how to test some hypotheses, estimate some marginal predictions, and create some plots after we finish fitting the model. So I'm going to be using the NHANES 2L dataset, and you can download this from the State of Servers by typing webuse NHANES 2L. And here I've described the three variables that we'll be using for this model. High BP is an indicator for high blood pressure. That's our binary dependent variable. Age, measured in years, is our continuous predictor. And health status is our categorical predictor. Notice that there is a value label attached to health status, so at HLT. So I've typed label list HLTH here. And that displays the various categories of health status. So one indicates excellent health status, two indicates very good, and so forth. This A dot is a missing value category, and that category will be removed from our model, so we don't need to worry about that. So let's begin by going to statistics, and I'm going to scroll down to binary outcomes and select logistic regression. So my binary dependent variable is high BP, so that's down here near the bottom. And then for my independent variables, I'm going to use this little three-dot box to set this up. So I'm going to click that, and I'm going to leave factor variable selected at the top. And so for the main effect, I'm going to begin by selecting age. So age is right here. Age is a continuous variable, so I'm going to check this little box underneath C-dot. That tells Stata that age is a continuous variable. And I'm going to add that to the variable list. So then I'm going to click OK, and then submit. And Stata, the dialog box has created the command logistic, followed by the binary dependent variable high BP, followed by the variable age. Now age, Stata assumes that age is a continuous variable. That's the default. So we'll come back to that here in a moment. Let's add health status to our model. So I'm going to come back to the dialog box and click the little three-dot box again. And again, I'm going to leave main effect selected, and this time I'm going to select health status. So that's right here. Health status is categorical, so I'm not going to check this box underneath C-dot. Okay, so that'll make it categorical. And I'm ignoring time series operators in the base option and all of that. So I'm going to click Add to Var List, so that adds health status to my variable list. And I'm going to click OK, and then Submit again. So now, the command is still logistic, same dependent variable, age is still here. Now, health status has been added to the list of covariates. And notice that there's an I dot in front of health status. The I dot tells Stata explicitly that health status is a categorical variable, and it creates the indicator variables for each category for me, so I don't have to. Okay, so that's how I include health status as a categorical variable. Let's go back to the dialog box now and include an interaction between the two. So here where it says specification, I'm going to select interaction two-way. So now this allows me to select two variables. So again, I'm going to select age as a continuous variable. So I'm going to check the box underneath C-dot. And then I'm going to select health status right here. And I'm not going to check the box under C because it's a categorical variable. Then I'm going to click Add to Var List. And now notice something's been added here to Var List. We'll talk about that in a moment. So if I click OK and click Submit, now if I scroll back up and look at the command, the dialog box has added C.health and then a little sharp or hashtag here, followed by health stat. So what does this mean? C dot now tells Stata explicitly that age is a continuous variable. And then the little hashtag or sharp here, that's an operator. That's the interaction operator. So it tells Stata that we want to see the interaction of age treated as continuous and health status treated as a categorical variable. So in an interaction term, Stata assumes that a variable that doesn't have an operator at the beginning is categorical. So Stata is assuming health status is categorical. Now, notice there's an I dot over here. We could put the I dot in front of health status here in the interaction term, and that would be just fine. That wouldn't cause any problems at all. Notice that there's no C dot in front of age over here in the main effect, but we could add the C dot there if we wanted to, and that wouldn't cause any problems either. In fact, we can have C dots and I dots in front of everything here, and that just tells Stata explicitly how we want to treat our covariates. Okay, so let's go back to the dialog box and let me show you a shorthand way to do this. So I'm going to delete everything from this independent variables window here, click the three-dot box again, and from down at the bottom where it says var list, I'm going to delete that stuff as well. So let me show you a shorthand way to do this. If I go to specification and select two-way full factorial, now I can simply select those variables, age, and check the box next to continuous, and health status, and I'm not going to check the box because this is a categorical variable. I'm going to add that to the var list, click OK, and I'm going to go ahead and click OK this time because I'm done with the dialog box. Now it's simply specified the independent variables as c.age, hashtag, hashtag, health stat. So that double hashtag or double sharp is another operator that tells Stata that we want to see both the main effect of age, treated as continuous, and the main effect of health status, treated as categorical, as well as the interaction. So that double hashtag asks for both main effects and the interaction all at the same time. Just to emphasize that you can do this, I'm going to go back in here and put an I dot. I just clicked on the command in the history window. That put it here in the command window. And now I've been completely explicit about this. C.age, I.healthstat, and then the double hashtag. So when I press enter, now it's created the main effect, or estimated the main effect of age, the main effect of health status, as well as the interaction of health status and age. So at the top of the output, I see my model level statistics, the number of observations, the likelihood ratio chi-square, the p-value, the pseudo r-squared, and then I see odds ratios for each of the main effects as well as the interactions, along with their standard errors and so forth. Now, let's think about this interaction for a moment. Is there a statistically significant interaction between health status and age? Well, we actually have four different odds ratios estimated here. And some of the p-values are less than 0.05, and some of them are greater than 0.05. And what if we wanted to test all of these interactions simultaneously? What I can do is I can type test parm, followed by i.hltstat, make sure I don't misspell it, and then the single hashtag, and c.age, and then press enter. And what that's going to do is simultaneously test that all of those interaction coefficients are equal to zero, or equivalently that all of those odds ratios are equal to one simultaneously. So it's going to report one omnibus chi-square test for that as well as a p-value. Okay, so that's how we could test for that entire interaction all at once. Another thing that we might want to do is estimate marginal predictions from our model. So I'm going to go to statistics and scroll almost all the way down and select post-estimation. And that opens Stata's post-estimation selector. So after I fit pretty much any kind of regression model, I can select the post-estimation selector and do things like goodness of fit analysis, predictions, tests, contrasts, and things like that. I want to do some marginal predictions. So I'm going to expand this menu where it says marginal effects, estimated means, and interactions. And I'm just going to do some basic stuff. So I'm going to select basic and low dimensional analysis and click launch. And here that opens the margins dialog box. And in the main tab, I can select the covariates that I want to consider. So let's start with health status. Health status is a categorical predictor or covariate. And I'm going to select health status. Stata knows that that's the only categorical predictor or covariate in the model. And then for the analysis type, I'm just going to do marginal means of outcomes for levels of covariate here. I don't need to specify any values to compute the estimates at because this is categorical. So I'm going to click submit, and the dialog box is going to issue the command margins followed by health stat. And what that's going to do is estimate marginal predicted probabilities of high blood pressure for each category of health status. So for someone who has excellent health status, the predicted probability of hypertension is 0.39. For someone with poor health status, the predicted probability of health status is 0.5. Now, because the model includes age and the interaction of age and health status, these predicted probabilities are adjusted for age and that interaction. So I'm looking at the predicted probabilities for hypertension for each category of health status, but it is adjusted for the other variables in the model. Now, we might want to also consider the interaction of health status with age in our predictions. So I'm going to come back to the dialog box and check this box that says interaction analysis with another covariate. And the other covariate in the interaction is continuous, so I'm going to select continuous. The only continuous covariate in the model is age, and now I do need to specify values to compute estimates at. So I'm going to specify 20 in increments of 10 through 80. So this tells Stata to estimate the predicted probabilities at age 80 through age, from age 20 to age 80 in increments of 10. Okay. So I'm going to click OK. And now I'm going to come back up here and look at the command. The command now says margins health stat, comma, at age 20 through 80 in increments of 10. And that's why I see all of this output, because at 1 refers to at age 20, at 2 refers to age 30, and so forth to age 80. So if I look at the output here, now 1 refers to age 20. So the predicted probability of hypertension for a 20-year-old in excellent health is about 0.14 if I were to round that. For someone who is age 80 in excellent health, the predicted probability of hypertension is about 0.74 rounded. And I get standard errors, Z statistics, p-values, and a 95% confidence interval for each of those predicted probabilities. Now, another thing that I can do is I can plot these. So if I come back to the post-estimation selector, I'm going to select profile plots after marginal analysis. So then I'm going to click launch, and this opens the margins plot dialog box. So for the variables that define the x-axis, I'm going to select at age. And let's click submit and see what that does. So this creates a profile plot for age, with age on the horizontal axis, the predicted probability of hypertension on the vertical axis, and then I see a separate line for each category of health status: excellent, good, poor, very good, and fair. So I see each of those lines here, and so there's a dot at each point where there's a prediction, and there's a confidence interval around that prediction. If I want to, I could see each of these a separate plot for each category by coming back to the dialog box. And here where it says create subgraph for groups defined by variables, I could select health status. And when I click submit, what that will do then is create a separate graph for each category of health status. Or if I prefer, I'm going to remove that. And another thing I can do is create graphs for groups defined by variables. I could select health status here and click submit. And what that will do, it happens so fast, I don't know if you could see that, but if I come back up here, that creates an entirely separate graph for each category of health status. So this is the predicted probability for the excellent, for people with excellent health status, very good health status, fair, and poor. So we can create the graph separately if we want as well. And then we can customize these with titles and colors and things like that if we wanted to. So let me close all of this, and I want to show you one last little trick you can do here. I'm going to come to the history window here on the left, and I'm going to right-click anywhere and select Select All. And then I'm going to right-click again and select Send Selected to Do File Editor. And what that will do is send all of those commands to the Do File Editor, so I can see each of the commands that were generated by the dialog box. And I can save this file, and then I can rerun my analyses anytime I want. It's also a handy way to learn about the names of these options for various commands, so it's a handy learning tool as well. Okay, so that's how we can fit a logistic regression model that includes the interaction of a continuous and a categorical predictor variable. We can test some hypotheses, we can estimate some marginal predictions, as well as create some graphs. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.